So, I was watching The Sound of Metal the other day. I saw a scene where the protagonist, Riz Ahmed, goes upstairs and checks his email. And guess what? The app he uses. Proton Mail. It's becoming incredibly popular, being featured in films and, of course, now in many people's phones and on the desktop. Today, we're going to overview whether Proton Mail is a good solution for you. This is a secure, privacy-focused email application, but we're going to really unpack it and see whether it's suitable for you. Today's video is kindly sponsored by Zapier. A little bit more about them later. So, as you can imagine, Proton Mail wants to be a secure experience. The founder was previously working at CERN. He left and started Proton Mail, and it is deemingly a very well put together application. It has very fast applications and has a lineup of other pieces of software like Calendar, Drive, VPN, and more. And we're going to particularly look at the mail experience for this and how it operates. So I think the first thing to look at is the pricing. There is a free plan. That is good news. And you can access a Proton.me account, which is your go-to email address, as well as some features. You get up to 1 gigabyte of storage, and I'll explain that a little bit later. But there are additional pricing plans, and there is Mail Plus, Proton Unlimited, and Proton Duo. All of these allow you more access to the other applications, but the basic pricing does allow you to get access to the more advanced mail features. Unlimited gives you access to all of the different workspace softwares. So here you get access to up to 15 gigabytes of storage for £3.99 a month. I'll try to include the pricing below for your country and the desktop applications, as well as using your own domain address, which is really helpful. You also get unlimited folders, 10 email addresses and aliases, but as part of the unlimited, you get access to all of the other applications, which is incredibly helpful, obviously. Ever wanted to automate things, but you lack the coding skills? You can now do that with Zapier with no code. Zapier is the leader in automation, allowing you to take your workflows to the next level with a suite of automation tools. You can go from an idea to reality in no time, setting up triggers for simple workflows and for even more advanced ones. That's why over 2.2 million companies use and trust Zapier. And thanks to Zapier for sponsoring this video. So in terms of what you get in the free plan, as you can see, this is the desktop version. I've got a 14-day free trial, but you will not get this as part of the basic free pricing, although you do get access to the Android and iOS versions, which is pretty good because those apps are very fast. These look great. I have had some slight issues with it in terms of just some speed elements, but of course it has worked 85 to 90% well throughout my test. As you can see here, it looks pretty much like an email client. You can open the email, respond to the email, but as you can see, I've got a new email address, and this is a protected email address using the Proton security systems. It is end-to-end encrypted and also allows me to use this without being tracked. So each of your emails have this little tick in the corner, and basically signifies whether there are any trackers found as part of this. And that could be through an email campaign, through another person using a CRM or whatever it may be, but it allows you to block the tracker and clean links as well, which is very helpful. So that sort of protects you against any tracking. And also the app has no advertisements as part of that. And naturally they state that they do not sell your data either as part of whatever plan you're using as part of Proton. So as you can see, you can reply to the email, you can schedule an email for later, although there are some limitations. You do need the premium pricing to access some of them. You can add attachments, even an expiry time, as well as requesting a read receipt too, which is not completely off the grid as part of this account. Now, the application sort of reminds me of a slightly more attractive version of Apple Mail. It has the same feel, the same presence, and as you can see on this right-hand side, you can open your contacts list. You can see your Proton calendar, allowing you to create an event and correlate it to your Proton Mail. And there's an additional feature where you can go into more detail on, for example, creating aliases and using some of the other features. There's other abilities like Sentinel, which allows you to see all of the different logins that may be coming through your account and protect that, as well as dark web monitoring. there's quite a few detailed features for those who are on the premium pricings. So it's well worth having a look if security is even more paramount to you, in which you can go into more detail on. So you can modify the layout a little bit more like a column layout, traditional, and you can sync the themes as well, which is as part of that. There is a settings area where you can see how much storage you do have. I mentioned at the start of this video, I have 1 gigabyte storage as part of the free plan, but you have a limit of 500. And if you increase your storage, you can by double if you complete their checklist within the first 18 days of getting started with your account. Now you can see there's a separate drive storage, so you do get access to the other applications, but there are some limitations to how much storage you can actually have. And I'm sure that will go pretty fast if you're using it. But you can see that Proton unlimited users get 500 gigabytes of storage free, which is pretty good, as well as the other based features around using it. So there are some additional abilities. You can change and modify your appearance. You can see how the security is monitoring your account by revoking access, as well as checking in on other third-party applications that are connected. But largely, there's quite a high level of detail. You can use something called Proton Mail Bridge, which is a paid experience as part of the unlimited plan and Mail Plus, which allows you to use Proton Mail through other applications that have IMAP included. So you can see and modify your folders and filters, but there isn't a well-rounded productivity system as part of that. For example, if you're using a no Gmail, you can't go in there and it automatically organize your emails for you. You're pretty much just going to get everything through. It's probably part and parcel with the system. And for those who want a more privacy-focused application, you're probably not worrying too much about it. So largely, there is still the regular stuff you'd expect, like move to spam, but there's more detailed features as well, like the ability to view headers so that you can see the whole email in its raw text and raw format, which is very helpful. And over here, you can set up auto-forwarding to Gmail, which allows you to sign in through your Gmail account and automatically forward it to the application, allowing you to use the Proton Mail blockers and encrypt the email so that you don't get it sort of filters through before it arrives to you. But the application does have a well-built experience for managing your inbox. So should you get Proton Mail? It is an interesting application. It obviously is one of the best in class in terms of security, and that's one of the primary focuses of it. They've also got a workspace experience, which helps you to manage the calendar and the drive, and also even use things like the password security and VPN. So they're trying to approach this as a bigger picture situation, a little bit like what Skiff was trying to do with their privacy aspects as an alternative to Proton Mail. But they do a really good job of this. In terms of the detailed security features, I can't particularly comment on that, but the way they've put together the packages like Sentinel and even the Proton Mail Bridge, it does wreak the sense of security and privacy around managing your inbox. So I've not heard any negative reviews about this application. In the last year or so, they have had some downtime, so I'm hearing from other creators. However, the application has been on the market for a fair bit of time now. It is protected under Swiss law, which is quite particular about how they manage their email security and privacy. So that is another bit of good news if you're looking into that. But as per normal, I would recommend you doing your homework on the privacy and security that matters most to you. In terms of the pricing as well, the Proton Unlimited plan is actually a really good offering. If you're looking for something that's more open plan and has a lot more features and offers a lot for your value of money, for £8 a month, I feel like this is a good offering. You would have to be willing to leave a few things behind and play some of their games in terms of getting access to other things. But if your security is a problem or worry for you, then this might be the next choice for you. So if you're Riz Ahmed from Sound of Metal, or you're just the average Joe or Josephine at home, you'll probably enjoy this application. It is fast, easy to use, and has security in mind. I'll include links to it below, but if you're searching for more email clients that are security focused, jump over to toolfinder.co. Thanks to Zapier for sponsoring this video, and feel free to check out everything in the description below. Feel free to comment if you've used Proton Mail and want to share some of your experiences. Thanks so much for stopping by, and I'll see you very soon. Cheerio.